I'm going to introduce to you someone today who has found great success. His team was part of the 2012 Innovation Challenge, and he has found some great success over the last couple years. Alex Epstein, come on up and talk to us about Sideguards.
2 years ago, my team proposed an idea that would save the lives of people on bikes, on foot, or on motorcycles, and save fuel for truck operators. Let's take a look at 2 years later. This was the distinguished panel of judges back then in 2012 in a little conference room just outside the hallway here. That was the inaugural run. And to this panel of judges, we presented the well-known fact that aerodynamic equipment, like the side skirts that most of you have probably seen on the highways, are already known to reduce fuel consumption for trucks. And we pointed out the untapped potential for side guard usage like this, where they could also function to potentially prevent grisly carnage. About 110 people a year are killed when they fall under the side of a moving truck. And we furthermore proposed expanding the horizon from just looking at tractor trailers, but also looking at the kinds of single unit trucks that we see in cities where these types of deaths occur. And we also proposed piggybacking on the international standards that already existed in most of the developed world, in some cases up to 30 years. A week later was that city of Boston noticed, and they came to us for help to make their truck fleet safer because they had just experienced a rash of 5 people who had died in preventable crashes. And within 6 months, Volpe worked with the city of Boston to develop the largest pilot program of side guards in the United States. Neighboring communities and even private companies followed suit in eastern Massachusetts. Within 8 months of our proposal, NTSB said virtually the same thing. The National Transportation Safety Board came out with a landmark report of single unit truck crashes and recommended that NHTSA actually develop performance standards and require them on all trucks over 10,000 pounds. It's kind of uncanny. So we continued the dialogue and developed our own 2-page technical overview on this topic of this technology. And at the same time, City of Boston was contemplating their next move to continue their safety program when one of their first sideguard outfitted trucks collided with a bicyclist. The bicyclist survived. Mayor Walsh immediately wanted truck sideguards in all the contracted vehicles in the city and engaged Volpe. Volpe worked with the City of Boston to craft what became the nation's first sideguard ordinance requiring these technologies on trucks in the city. New York City engaged this as part of their Vision Zero program, their sweeping campaign to eliminate traffic fatalities within 10 years. And one of the planks became making trucks safer with this type of technology. It's been an exciting year, and it was actually capped off with the NTSB expanding their original sideguard recommendation now to tractor trailers. Looking ahead, I think the horizon expands even further. I expect that Volpe will continue to work with the City of New York on the Vision Zero program, expand our work with the local partners, Boston, Cambridge, and expand our view to crash prevention technologies, sensors, alarms, mirrors. Work on voluntary programs to adopt these technologies like we've seen in London, and even NHTSA might turn around given a statement we saw this summer that they might actually consider this, and if and when they do, I assure you Volpe will be in a strong position to support any kind of sideguard movement on that front.